This week, you guys are going to be shooting panoramas. Panoramas are super fun, and there's a lot of different options that you can do for panorama week. So, what panoramic photography is, it's a special technique. Nowadays, on smartphones, they make it super easy for you to take panoramas. There are several different kinds of panoramas, and we're just going to kind of explore those today. At the bare minimum, you guys have to take at least 180 degree panoramas. They should look very wide, covering a large area. If you want to go a little step further, you can make 360 degree panoramas, which go all the way around and are extremely wide and cover the whole scene. Now, if you do take a 360 panorama, you can also do what is called a spherical or a little planet. So there are many apps out there to help you with this, and they really make it so simple and easy to do to get these cool effects. So Android users, Tiny Planet, Planicle, Mirror Lab, they get all those tiny planet effects. And then for Apple, there's many apps out there as well, like Circular, Roll World, Theta Plus, they'll all give you that little planet feel. Now, again, you at the bare minimum have to do 180 degree panorama, but if you want to do a 360 or a spherical, you're allowed to do that this week as well. So here's an example of a spherical. Here's a couple other examples of sphericals. And again, you can use your camera app to make this relatively easy on you. This here is an example of a 180 degree panorama, just going horizontally. And then here's a vertical panorama going up 180 degrees. So vertical panoramas are really interesting to look at because they don't normally occur. So the one on the left is a church, and then the one on the right is just in a high rise looking up. They did Photoshop the sky and add stars. Here's some more examples of vertical panoramas. When you're doing your vertical panoramas, there's a specific way that you should hold your iPhone. I would hold it horizontally so that you can get a lot of space on your left and right. Now, this person here, they did not go up far enough. So, this is a pretty common problem. You need to go further up when you're doing your vertical panoramas if you choose to do this option. Now, here are some horizontal options. Again, at minimum 180 degrees. And then sometimes when you're close to objects, you'll have this like kind of warped like effect that is pretty normal. And you can go anywhere for your panoramas. You don't have to go anywhere fancy. I'm just looking for kind of understanding this week. Now, before smartphones, when we used cameras, we would have to take individual images and stitch them together in Photoshop. As of right now, I'm not having you do that, but just know that there is a way to take photos separately by overlapping them and stitching them together to create a panorama. Overall, I do want you to take your panoramas outside. Again, it doesn't have to be a fancy place. And that's pretty much it. So you can pretty much take a panorama anywhere. Again, at minimum 180 degrees. If you do want to do a 360, you can. If you want to do a spherical, you can. You can mix and match for your panoramas. You're not limited to just one thing. If you are shooting with your cell phone, I would definitely use the panorama setting on your cell phone or download one of the apps to do panoramas. If you are shooting with a camera, you can stitch them together by overlapping, but this week, I would say the majority of you should be shooting with a cell phone for Panorama Week. So if you have questions, just let me know.